Hello and welcome. The big day has arrived. Voting has got over to the elections in India, the seven-phase polling. And now we are looking at the exit poll numbers which are coming. And we are looking specifically at the two Telugu states of Andhra Pradesh and Telangana. And with me is Dr. Venugopal Rao of the Center for Cephalology Studies, who has done extensive surveys in both the Telangana and Andhra Pradesh states. Dr. Rao, we'll start with Andhra Pradesh because there's a huge amount of interest as to who is winning Andhra Pradesh. Yes. We'll come to who is winning later. We'll go district by district, region by region as to who is leading, and we'll also look at the key constituencies in each of the districts. So let's start from the north coastal sides. Let's start from Srikakulam. Srikakulam Lok Sabha constituency, represented by Ramohan Naidu, son of the late Aram Naidu. What are the exit poll numbers? What are the post poll surveys that you have done telling about Srikakulam Lok Sabha constituency?
Srikakulam, our survey has given a seat to TDP, MP wise.
Okay.
And, this because two factors. One is, he played an active role in the eyes of the people in the parliament in terms of his articulation and all that. And secondly, he's the son of a late leader who has done something to that region and the people.
Yes.
Respected. And third thing is that, some of the segments also, generally, Srikakulam used to be a strong bastion of Telugu Desam. So all these factors in the surveys, both the times it came, and so we gave that.
So Ramohan Naidu, you are saying, is ahead as far as Srikakulam is concerned. What about the assembly constituencies in Srikakulam?
In the assembly constituencies, it is simple that, we gave five seats to YCP and four seats to TDP. One, we have kept it as a very, very keen close contest.
Which is this constituency which is seeing a close
contest? Srikakulam proper.
Srikakulam proper. Okay. So, at least the first district that we are talking about, five to the YSR Congress, four to the TDP, and one is seeing a close contest. Mm-hmm. And the Lok Sabha constituency, you are saying, would go to the TDP. So, that's that would bring some kind of cheer to the TDP, at least to start with. Vizianagaram. Strongman Ashok Gajpati Raju, former Union Civil Aviation Minister, comes from here. He is contesting the Vizianagaram Lok Sabha constituency. His daughter Aditi was contesting from the assembly constituency in the same Vizianagaram Lok Sabha constituency. What is the prognosis as far as Vizianagaram is concerned?
Vizianagaram MP seat will go to YSRCP.
Okay.
And even assembly seats also, they are just, TDP is getting just two. And then, that means the six seats are going to YCP and only two seats are going to TDP, and one is a very, very clean, keen, close contest, that is Vizianagaram proper.
So that's not good news coming from you for Ashok Gajpati Raju. I mean, his long innings in politics may see some kind of a speed breaker as far as this Lok Sabha election is concerned. Visakhapatnam, another extremely crucial district given a number of high profile personalities who are fighting from here. Visakhapatnam Lok Sabha constituencies, which saw Lakshmi Narayan of the Janasena, former CBI Joint Director, Purandareshwari of the BJP contesting, and of course, Chandrababu Naidu's brother-in-law, son-in-law, Sri Bharat, contesting on behalf of the TDP. But the YSR Congress would have an edge in Visakhapatnam as well?
Actually, as per the survey is concerned, it was a seat of TDP, it was, but very close angle of around 1% votes only.
But the BJP, won last time in 2014, Hari Babu.
It does not matter. It's the BJP's gone case in terms of the numbers and vote share is concerned in Andhra Pradesh. Though a strong lady who worked as MP also earlier is contesting, but in the eyes of the people, BJP and Congress are out.
In 2014, they spoke about a Narendra Modi wave, in a Narendra Modi vote in the urban centers like Vizag. You don't think that's present anymore?
No, that's what I'm saying. For a BJP, no.
It
works for TDP. And but what happened was that, once the JD Lakshmana came into the picture, apparently, instructions are given to vote for J.D. Lakshminarayana, not for the TDP. So, we can't establish those things scientifically. But if that is the case, even whether instructions or no instructions, once the J.D. Lakshminarayana comes into the picture, he cuts the base, which is a strong base of TDP, cuts the TDP and in turn indirectly help the YCP. So, this is a seat which was given for TDP in my survey, but ultimately my research team is thinking, sir, with the JD Lakshmana is vigorously putting it, probably it will help even YSRCP in the end. Mm-hmm.
So this also, this you are predicting as a tight contest.
Tight contest, yeah.
One of the assembly constituencies in Vizag district was Gajuwaka, from where Pawan Kalyan was contesting.
Yeah.
What is the forecast as far as the power star is concerned? Will he get power from Gajuwaka?
See, he was getting power, but suddenly became very far to the power by the time the elections approached. Is the Sarvesh second night of pre-polls away? Now what I am talking is an admixture of all the surveys. You see,
yes.
See, I have never come on to the media saying that about my, I mean it's electronic media. So I have evolved a very innovative methodology to predict. It is basically an admixture of pre-polls and a random exit polls, and then post-polls, few post-polls, and you know, it is basically a coagulation method where you screen out and then predict it. And so if that is the case, by the pre-poll, last pre-poll, Pawan Kalyan was ahead with 34% of the votes in that. But ultimately, the way the elections came, the way the TDP is you know, showing interest on Jan Sena, has indirectly helped YSRCP both in the assembly and also in the parliament seat.
What is the forecast for the remaining assembly seats in Vizag?
Like this, 9 are going to YCP, okay. 4 are going to TDP, okay. And very close contest. I put this Gajuwaka, Pawan Kalyan, and very close contest, and Anakapalli as a close contest. But it's an advantage to TDP. Okay. So if that is the case, 9-5 or something like that.
Okay. East Godavari.
East Godavari is the only when district both are performing equally. What we have given is around 9 seats to YCP and 10 seats to TDP out of 19.
And Kakinada, you were telling me, is a Lok Sabha constituency where the TDP could be in with a chance.
Could be within a chance. Now looks like, you know, most of 9 also have increased more. Probably 10, 11, it might reverse. If there is a Kakinada was not there, probably it might change also by the time elections come. But I am not sure, but it is a very, very tight contest and all that.
West Godavari, again a district where Pawan Kalyan was contesting from a second seat in Bhimavaram. Has that kind of invigorated the Janasena vote base in West Godavari district?
In most of the places, they have played a role. They are coming in second place. TDP is pushed into third place.
That's very significant. You are saying that the YSRCP may win, but it will be Janasena who will be number 2 and not TDP.
In most of the...
But that's only in West Godavari district?
That's only in West Godavari district. So
in almost all the constituents?
In almost all, not all. 70% of the consensus, 60%, sorry, 60% of the consensus, Janasena will be second. And rest of the things are TDP will be the second. And wherever they are winning, actually they are winning very less around 9 seats are going to YCP and then 5 seats are going to TDP. And one, this Bhimavaram is contesting, is in the first pre-poll survey, he came very close. And then say around 34%, which is very close, there will be 1%, 2% difference of the, for the YCP. And by the time election came, though is performing very well in this district, second place and all, but in Bhimavaram, by the local calculations, even that also it becomes difficult for Pawan Kalyan to win.
I think also the fact that Jagan had gone on record saying that whoever defeats Pawan Kalyan, the candidates, or in Nara location, Mangalgiri, will be taken into the cabinet. So that kind of gave an impetus also to the YSRCP candidates to work a little more hard. There was that motivation factor also. Another character or personality who was pretty active as far as the West Godavari district was concerned was K.A. Paul. He was expected to play a spoiler of sorts for the YCP because of all the confusion about the candidates' names, about the symbol of his helicopter looking a bit like the ceiling fan. The YSRCP went to the election commission to complain. Has K.A. Paul played any role whatsoever in this election?
No, he created confusion and fear among the YCP, saying fear. That fear in the sense in terms of a symbol that it might create a confusion, but they got alert by the advice of the people like us, saying that you specifically, because in Telangana, because of such a symbol, 4 seats were lost to TRS very clearly. See, it is a mind game, it is a absolutely a direction from the very experienced leader to put in.
Mm.
And that the looks like the factors that were working in term this man's entry is somebody's very strong guidance.
Mm.
No, this man comes to at the time of elections, last times also here and there he comes. But this time he is seriously put by some forces behind, saying that he should play a spiral game. But by this symbol we alerted them, saying that, you know, we in the sense analysts alerted them, saying that you distribute the pamphlets where he has put the same name and then symbol.
Yes.
And that they have put it, they covered. Actually, they went into the election commission to cancel this, mm-hmm. but it was already late, election commission did not agree. But they chose other means by someone, saying that you distribute the pamphlets like a college where you show them to the people. So they took care of that.
And that seems to be quite a well rehearsed modus operandi. They did the same thing with TTV Dinakaran's candidates in Tamil Nadu, the same K-Paul strategy. So you are saying that he did not play much of a role of a spoiler?
He did not. He tried. He did not. First of all, he is not to be taken seriously. Only media is taking him.
He was more of a media creation in a sense.
The media budget, nothing more than that, nothing else.
Krishna district, the most politically volatile, seen as the political capital of Andhra Pradesh.
Yeah.
What is the forecast as far as Krishna district is concerned?
Krishna district, you know, we have given also very, very huge number to YSRCP. It is,
despite it being a TDP bastion.
Yeah. It is 11 and 4, 11 to ICP and 4 to.
And Vijayawada Lok Sabha constituency again between KC Neni Nani and.
Actually, in the pre polls definitely 1% ahead to TDP,
mm.
but post polls and the developments and all that, it is YCP is clicking that also,
mm.
and so only one seat which we have Vijayawada Central we have given a close fight, but apparently. See, I told you very clearly that if you take Reddy's, BC's, SC's, Christians, Muslims, there are no numbers on the other side.
You are saying you are including Muslims also despite the feeling that Jagan could go with the BJP post elections.
That won't work at all. That's right. It does not. Actually, he has made. You see, they don't see him like, you know, with pro-Modi and all that. They only TDP tries to put those things into the minds of Muslims. They're very clear.
You think that did not work as a strategy? So he must have got the minority vote also.
He has got 70% of the minority vote.
Okay.
90% of Christians vote.
Mm.
70% of the Muslims votes. 65 to 70% of SCST votes.
Let's come to the Guntur district because that's where there are a number of personalities. Nara Lokesh from Mangalgiri. Last time, Alla Ramakrishna Reddy won by a slender scrape through by just 12 votes. This time, Chandrababu Naidu fielded Nara Lokesh. There was resistance to his candidature by a lot of locals who expected probably a Padmashali to be given the ticket. That did not happen. Do you see Nara Lokesh winning from Mangalgiri?
That was a wrong choice of Chandrababu Naidu to put Nara Lokesh into that constituency. You see, elections, each elections are different.
Mm.
It is not like that, you know, last time elections will be the same.
Mm.
The sense there was a less majority, mm. the opponent candidate win, this time this man will win.
Mm.
There they made a calculation, by calculation wrong.
Mm.
What happens is, last time the so many factors worked in favor of. The farmers were huge and then they were employees and they were, you know, the students and so many sections, BCs were with them and all that. And so this time all of them have turned in favor of a YCP candidate.
And Ramakrishna Reddy was also seen as someone who fought for the farmers on the capital issue.
Man. Comparing in the last election, putting the candidate itself was wrong, number one. Number two, the people have taken him as a local candidate who has fought for the issues.
Mm-hmm.
Number three, Lokesh, once he gets elected, he gets into the government, he will not be successful.
Mm.
Number three. Number four, media campaign, which he was telling, was rated very low, Lokesh.
Mm.
Number five, social media has dubbed him like anything. Then number six, very, very, very crucial, saying that, you know, the caste arithmetic.
Yeah.
I have the numbers where, you know, the major dominant caste are 4, 5. All are in favor of YCP.
Mm.
You know, Padmashali is around 20-24,000.
Mm.
Padmashalis are numerically strong.
Mm.
Next Muslims are strong. Next Reddys are in 3-4 mandals are,
yeah,
strong. SCSTs are sizable numbers. And so these are the numbers which itself make 1,20,000 votes.
Mm.
other side, even if you give them the entire number, there are only 60,000. 60,000 numbers, you know, Kamas around 20,000 and, you know, Kapus. Kamas around 15,000, Kapus around 20,000. Even then split would have come because of power.
So what is the vote margin that you are looking at in Mangalagiri specifically?
You see, by poll surveys, it showed around 6%, 6 to 7%, and now by the time elections approach, saying that there will be big big effort by the ruling party, and then they must have reduced the margin to 3 to 4%.
Right.
TDP cannot make it.
So the big news that you're giving as far as the star constituency, the VIP constituency of Mangalagiri is concerned, is that Nara Lokesh could face defeat in Mangalagiri.
Not only that, let me add you, this particular constituency has all through been with the YCP in my surveys. I did in 2017 July, it went to YCP. I did in 2018 January, 2019 January, it went to YCP. I did it in February, it went to YCP. Even April, it went into the YCP. Post polls, to the perceptions and then talks, the atmosphere is in terms of YCP. Only thing, that particular constituency faced a heavy lot of technical problems with EVM. People say that.
And voting went on till very late.
But that has already decided. But people are putting some doubts into the minds of the.
There is another constituency where there were a lot of hangama that day, which is where Kodela Shivprasad Rao was contesting from. How are the other assembly constituencies in Guntur district looking?
No, Guntur is a sweep to YCP. We are giving only 14, we are giving only 2 seats to TDP and 14 seats to YCP and 1 keen contest. What happens is that, you know, once again the larger numbers of SCSTs and then BCs and of course Kapus and Kamas are there, but there's a division has taken place and because the contesting candidates are also from the both this thing and all that, and you know these are the keenly fought things like, you know, Satyanapalli and all that and Silklur Beta and all these things. But what happened was Satyanapalli, it was very keen, narrow fight, 2% and all that, but the way he projected and the time of election day, that has gone negatively in favor of him, and it is going to give slightly more majority to the YCP than to that person, TDP candidate.
So it would be safe to assume from what you have told so far, at least half of Andhra Pradesh from North Coastal to Coastal, that a large number of seats are going to the YCP and not to the TDP, and the TDP could be looking at a huge defeat.
The way the numbers speak, whether they are seeing or not, but
your exit poll and post poll figures show that they're
in for a defeat. Yeah.
Nellore and Prakasam, these are two districts where you are saying that the TDP is not likely to pick up even a single seat. Is that the way it is looking for the TDP?
Yes, my data clearly show that they will not open an account there. But what would be the interesting is that there will be around 4 seats, there will be a fight
in with the districts.
Yeah, you see the things like, you know, Kondepi and Addanki. Apparently there is a fight, but Addanki is a lot of talked about, saying that, you know, TDP people are, you know, relying on that seat. But my survey showed that the TDP is far behind in terms of Nabuke.
And Addanki is also seen as a bellwether seat, right?
I don't think Addanki TDP can make it. The difference between the YCP and TDP candidate is more than 15%. It becomes very difficult to cover.
The other 4 Rayalaseema region districts now.
Other cities, Kondepi, where they think that there is a fight, but that also YCP will win. Okay. That makes the 2 seats in the counting day in the boxes. It will generate a heat, but ultimately it will go to YCP. Yeah. Nellore is also a sweep, but they're in 2 places where there will be fight, Kavali and Atmakore. Because Kavali, in the surveys pre-polls, it showed to the TDP, but in the post-polls, it showed to the YCP. So we have given it to YCP. And Atmakore all through being a YCP, but in the post-poll, TDP was showing a fight. But ultimately, we gave an edge to YCP. Okay. So that makes the TDP score 0 there. In that,
we'll come to Rayalaseema, Kurnool district, which saw a huge number of desertions in terms of MLAs moving over from the YCP to the TDP, someone like Akhila Priya becoming a minister, the tourism minister in Chandrababu Naidu's cabinet. How has Kurnool reacted to all that which happened between 2014 and
19? No, Kurnool was only looking at one way. Kurnool, all these dynamics people did not bother. People were saying that last time we voted, we could not see Jagan as a CM. We want to see this time by voting that there is a possibility for him to become CM. Mm-hmm. By voting in the same way like last time, we are going to see our person as a lovable person as a CM. Mm-hmm. So that has not changed their mindset. Mm-hmm. And you know, Chandrababu Naidu's desperate efforts to make two faction leaders, KE and then Kotla, mm-hmm. make the families together, yeah. has not worked because these people, this time elections, they don't want to give to them, see court and all that, they were not with the people for all this.
But when you have a Kotla family, you have the KE family, and then you have the TG Venkatesh family, the powerful industrialist from Kurnool, all together in the TDP camp, wouldn't they all join forces and help TDP better? I mean, why would it be a negative?
They have decided this. For some families, they want to give them the rest this time. So even if they want to give them the rest, because the non-performance in terms of their own eyes, what has been done. Mm-hmm. The same thing, the Janmabhoomi approach and not doing to the larger sections of the people. And
so, Kotla Suryaprakash Reddy, in your opinion, made a wrong choice by moving from the Congress to the TDP, moving from one losing side to another?
Absolutely. Absolutely. Why he is, I don't know why he has not chosen YSRCP, what made him not to show, whether YSRCP has not done it, whether he has not taken a proper advice, I don't know. Mm-hmm. But I think he will realize that it's a wrong.
But Kurnool, where T.G. Venkatesh's son T.G. Bharat was contesting against Hafiz?
It's a serious. First of all, in the surveys itself, in the selection of candidates, and when you read them, Bharat was coming very not up to the mark according to the expectations of the people. Muslims are huge in number. Muslims, BCs, and Christians are very huge in number in Kurnool, and ACs. BCs, SCs, Christians, Muslims.
No, so against the caste arithmetic working in favor of YCP.
Yeah.
Kurnool is also home to the Nandyal parliamentary constituency, which was once represented by former Prime Minister P.V. Narasimha Rao. How does it look now? I mean, SPY Reddy, the former MP, passed away recently. How does it look like?
No, these are the seats when assembly segments are straight away coming to YCP.
And the same pattern of voting is being seen in Lok Sabha.
Even in Kurnool also. So these people have put very intelligently the parliament candidates. Mm. Kurnool and then this Nandya. Mm. So, and when the wave is there in favor of YCP in the assembly segments, I don't see any parliament.
Despite Chandrababu Naidu projecting himself in this election at least as a more of a national kind of a politician than just a state politician. Whereas Jagan is seen as a state Andhra politician.
They want a state leader. First you win the house, then go into the public. In Telugu there is a thing, you know, integalchira rachagalvale. So people say that, you know, he is going around doing the national party, they don't bother.
Leaders like Farooq Abdullah, etc., coming and campaigning in Ralsima did not help Naidu?
It will be taken as a joke. What is Farooq Abdullah can do it and how many Muslims can influence and all that. And Mamata has not spoken a word against the combination of Jagan and then KCR, if you observe. They spoke in their own language and not spoken against Jagan Reddy or the KCR. So all these leaders brought from one day and then show you how many people in our
didn't
work at all.
Kadapa, which is the home district of Jagan Mohan Reddy, a stronghold. You see a YCP repeating the Nellore Prakasam kind of a performance here?
Yes, definitely. There is only, you see, in the surveys, they were only giving fight in two assembly constituencies. One is Rajampet and another is Jammal Madugu. Rajampet they were giving because, you know, Balja, one caste man and Balja are in larger numbers, and Reddy's and Balja's were inherently rivals. Mm. And when we did the initially surveys, the efforts were not made to unite both of them. Mm. On the ongoing process, first time in Andhra Pradesh history, larger numbers of both the communities got together. Mm. And especially Reddy's got too much united this time then. So once those two the caste groups come together, definitely larger in numbers, so Rajampeta is ruled out. And with regard to Jammal Madugu, you know, once again two faction leaders were made to sit together and then made to contest. But what happened was that in a candidate, of course, Ramsubad and all that, other side, there's Adinarayan Reddy and all that, they made a patch up together. But ultimately, what I gathered the field from the in the post polls is that cadres have not come together, only leaders have come together, because these were the rivals for long standing. You just, because for one election, if you get together, it becomes very difficult for the cadre to digest that. And they have fought for so many days, they have lost their lives, and suddenly if you sit down and then say that we'll come, that has not worked, it won't work. And one second, actually 50% of the votes came in the survey to the YCP. Once these people have come together, it has come down to around 44-46%. Then my data is showing that probably this seat might go to what is the way it is going on. But by the time the elections ended, because it was taken very seriously by the YCP, and so they changed the police boss out there, and the thought of it that they went to the villages where so far they could not enter, and so many factors worked in favor of YCP in the end. So that also seat will go to YCP as per the calculation.
One of the big campaign issues was the murder of YS Vivekananda Reddy, Jagan Mohan Reddy's uncle, just before the the whole election process started. Was that a factor which played out?
Actually, TDP wanted to make a very big, larger issue, saying that these are the people are like this time, so don't vote for them. But that did not work. And saying that these people will come and do rowdyism and all that, and the inculcating fear. And if it comes, you know, your welfare schemes are taken away, your lands are grabbed and all that. But all this lingua already, Chandrababu spoke. You cannot speak the same thing, and this man is showing Navaratnalu has worked. And so many factors, special issues factor, and campaigning only blaming KCR, blaming Modi and all that. You know what people, already state is formed, and what to do with the KCR now? When the in the Rayalaseema itself trend is there, in the Kadapa is there, in that particular constituency, why do they lose it?
Yeah.
So that force that this man has to be made CM.
What kind of a huge margin is Pulivendra looking at?
Pulivendra, he's polling 72% of votes.
So it's a pretty much a sweep.
It's a very big sweep. The other candidate will get 20%. When you get, it means around 140,000 votes, this man will get, other persons will get around 30-40,000. So it's a huge.
Anantapur, again a TDP bastion in the otherwise Rayalaseema region, which is seen tilting towards a YSR Congress. Here you're saying that the TDP has managed to hold on to its strengths in pockets of Anantapur district. Very interesting, because J.C. Divakar Reddy was the used to be the MP from Anantapur. His son J.C. Pavan is contesting. His brother J.C. Prabhakar Reddy gave up his Tadipatri assembly seat for J.C. Asmit Reddy. So in a sense, you know, passing on the baton. Two sunrises. Are we likely to see two sunrises in Anantapur district?
The MP seat Divakar Reddy will lose, and that means his son will lose. Whereas assembly seat TDP might get. That too, there is a lot of silent voting, people will say, in the post polls, but they are strong bastions. It becomes difficult. That's why we gave that seat to TDP. Other than that, we have only given 4 seats to TDP and then for 10 seats to YCP.
He believes that the TDP is coming to power. And he, of course, will win from Anantapur. So we will know on the 23rd whether who is right, whether you are right or J.C. Pavan Reddy is right. Lastly, Chittoor, Chandrababu Naidu's home district. He's winning from...
Let me tell you, their strong belief is their political management and their electoral management. These are all very strong, roots to them. And, they believe in that. But what they lose is the societal dynamics in the societal laboratory that is working with the permutations and combination, which is heating up, which is cooling down, which is coming in favor of the other party, they forget it. But if at all they win with their confidence, which the gut feeling which they are saying, would be because of their own past practices and their past strength. But the data is not showing.
And I mean, his father Divakar Reddy, what he said has also become very controversial. That's a lot of money was spent by both parties in this particular election.
See, if at all that happens, my data will clearly show. that this man is in the edge and all that. And of course, they don't believe in the surveys. We have seen earlier also. And apparently, that is my native place actually. So when I born there, of course, though I'm Karnal, but I know the way they change the electoral is very interesting. Mm. But this time it will not work. You know, when the wave comes,
right,
none of them will stand.
Lastly, Kuppam constituency in Chittoor district, Chandrababu Naidu. Is his victory margin likely to see some kind of a negative effect as a result of the anti-incumbency against his government as a whole, or Naidu continues to have his Teflon coating?
No, see, we don't looking into all that. Just because an anti-incumbency, he will get less majority, he will get, that is his seat, he will get 60% of the things, 60-62% and all that. Probably last time also he would have got it, I have not checked up. And that is not the matter of concern or discussion. He will get it 60% of votes, and his coming less is not a reflection on the state. It is his seat and he will get it. What we have given is one town, Tirupati town, mm-hmm. and another is Chittoor proper. Then we gave it to Palamaner and then Kuppam. So these four only. Other things, that's what very interesting is. They think that they have fought very vigorously. There are so many calls to me saying that what will happen to Nagari, Roja, what will happen to Chandragiri. Mm. But people are with YCP, you can't help it. They want to give one chance to Jagan, they want to make him CM. If that is the mindset, with all the caste arithmetic working, nobody can stand.
So now that we have finished with all the districts, 13 districts of Andhra Pradesh, what are the final numbers that we are looking at? But before that, what's the vote share that we are looking at?
Vote share is very, very, very startling. You see, the last time
the difference was just about 2%.
1.6%. And this time the huge margin of 78% is coming to Jagan. 38% is being scored by the TDP. And
is it the TDP and the Janasena vote that has, is it the BJP and the Janasena vote that has moved away from the TDP, or is it also a huge anti-incumbency against the TDP?
It is a clamoring of people to make him chief minister. Once the people decide to give to the Jagan, it will become shoot up.
So you are saying it's a positive mandate for Jagan Mohan Reddy in Andhra Pradesh. How much does it translate in terms of number of seats?
Number of seats is 120 plus. What is happening is, one thing what I want to tell you, Sudhir, is that the lower limit for YCP would be 2/3 majority. That is 116 plus.
So you are saying that he will not get below 116.
He will not get below 116. 2/3 majority YCP is going to form the government. Mm. And anything 116, I have given only 120 plus, so around 4-5 seats. Mm. Upper limit to TDP will be 52.
Okay.
So 42-52 you can anywhere. Mm. And that can be between 116 to 124 or 125. The way the wave, post polls which I am seeing, the majorities that are coming to the winning candidates of YCP, even the pre-polls, showing double. That means there is an inherent wave which has worked, which TDP is not recognizing. TDP is only saying that we win because of Paspu Kunkuma beneficiaries, because of farmers, this thing, and
that has not worked.
Even if the women got those 4,000 rupees just a week before polling date.
No, you have to see that we have done the survey after they have taken 8,000 rupees. 4,000 rupees is the last thing. We have seen after they have taken two installments, surveys took place.
Yeah.
Then itself, Jagan was getting more of this SHG group's people. You see, it is not an NMRC vote of those SHG members to TDP. Even among them, 1% more score is Jagan is getting. When Jagan is getting 46, these people are getting 45. Whereas non-Dwakra members, they will be 50% of the people are voting for Jagan.
Mm.
Only 38-40% are voting to TDP. And
despite giving this 10,000 rupees to 97 lakh women, and most TDP leaders are banking heavily on the votes of these 97 lakh women, that even if 20% of those 97 lakh votes come this side, that would make a difference. You are saying that has not happened.
That has not happened because it's not 97, it is 90. Other side is 60 lakhs which they have not got anything. So out of 90, I am saying 46% have voted for Jagan. 45% have only voted out of them. In the overall picture, more women are voting for the Jagan.
Or the entire women.
Entire woman vote. And second thing is that we have tested it. Before the pre-polls, after they have taken, last thing they have taken, we have involved a very new technology, very new research method known as focus group discussion. There are known as FGDs, which only our people social scientists are quite more equipped. Make the people in group and then ask them. We have asked them. You see, those women are also equally politically divided. Half of the number this side, half of the number that side. Whosoever have got this TDP people, they have voted.
You gave the numbers for both the TDP and the YSR Congress. Is the Janasena likely to pick up any seats, or only those two seats of Gajuwaka and Bhimavaram where Pawan Kalyan could?
See, so it's like this. They are getting around 8%, 8 to 10% of the votes. What the party is expecting is other thing, that Nagababu seat, MP, that won't work. JD Lakshmana, I told you the dynamics. And those two, the other seats, one is Tenali, they are expecting because of a strong leader. And other thing which they are expecting is Guntur West because of Tota Chandrasekhar and all that. Tota Chandrasekhar and all won't work because the already votes are divided. And Tenali also, he comes second. He comes, Manohar, he will come second. And these two, very nail-biting finish. It can be the ball game of YCP or Jan Sena, but not TDP and all that. Yeah.
Okay, now that we have done with Andhra Pradesh, where Dr. Venugopal Rao is predicting a victory, almost a landslide victory for the YSR Congress, let's look quickly also at Telangana, where you have been saying that the TRS honeymoon, KCR's honeymoon with Telangana electorate continues. Do we see a similar kind of result as we saw in the December 2018 elections?
Definitely.
Or the Congress is bouncing back?
Congress has raised their hands much before the election started itself. They have not given any fight at all. They have given a fight only in Chevella.
That's also because of the candidate.
Candidate, and they tried to show that there is a fight in this Malkajgiri, and none of the places they have shown any fight. And that is in a situation where their party leaders themselves are deserting them. They have lost the hopes. And even the contesting candidates have also tried to help the BJP, that it is better to help them to get them more numbers than
You are referring specifically to Nizamabad.
Nizamabad and also in Karimnagar and things of these places. They thought if they can help them and all that. And
so the Congress tried to help the BJP in order to defeat the TRS. That's an interesting kind of...
In a very desperate situation. It's a desperate situation, but the members of...
Do you see the BJP gaining in Nizamabad or in Secunderabad Lok Sabha constituency?
No, they will come in second place, definitely. Nizamabad, they will come in second place. Karimnagar, they will not come into the second place, probably are coming also. But none of them could give fight to TRS. They try to reduce the margins of vote share to TRS, but all the winning seats.
So you are predicting a 16 out of 16 for TRS plus Asaduddin Owaisi from Hyderabad.
Yeah. Most of the people, you know, analysts and journalists are hopeful people there, that, you know, Secunderabad will go to BJP and then Chevella will go to Congress. If you see those national sophologists or whosoever are giving those numbers or tables, you see just two to both of them, either two to Congress and two to BJP. And, I don't think they are correct because they have not seen the ground realities. And then,
so you are predicting a sweep for the TRS in Telangana. So that's the big picture coming from the Center for Sophology Studies, that as far as Telangana is concerned, it's going to be a sweep for the TRS, 16 seats plus MIM getting the Hyderabad Lok Sabha constituency. And as far as Andhra Pradesh, the big election that was taking place, the fight between the TDP and the YSR Congress with Pawan Kalyan there as the third player, not really being able to make much of an impact, at least in terms of number of seats and not more than an 8 to 10% vote share. So there we are likely to see a sweep, a landslide victory for YS Jagannathan Reddy's YSR Congress Party. Thank you very much, Dr. Venugopal Rao, for speaking to us.
Thank you
very much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.